So are you looking to become a VR YouTuber? Do you have an Oculus Quest 2 and looking to find the highest quality you can get captured on the headset? Well, this is Lipnox VR and I've got the ultimate solution for you. This is my guide for recording the Oculus Quest 2 in 4K. But don't you worry if you already know how to do that or you're looking for more information, because this is pretty much a full VR YouTuber guide that I'm gonna do. But before we get into anything, I really want to show you guys how great this 4K footage looks in comparison to the footage you're recording normally. So you can see, especially on edges or on letters, there is a huge difference in clarity, and it really does make a dramatic difference to someone like me who has a 4K TV who's watching these videos on that 4K TV. You know, when you start getting into some of these recordings down to 720p and you try to expand that onto a big 4K 60-inch TV, it just looks grainy. It doesn't look great. So you can see why this is a big deal to get this fixed.
And how do we get this set up? Well, here are the details. First things first, we want to make sure SideQuest is set up, which is required to input the commands required to tell the headset we want to record in 4K. If you haven't done this step yet, I highly recommend Cass and Chari's SideQuest setup guide, which I will link below. So get that done and then come back here. Okay, so now that we're good there, here are some steps to tell the headset how we want to record. Step 1, turn on and plug in the headset to the PC. Open SideQuest and make sure the headset is being recognized. Step 2, look to the top right for a box with an arrow pointed right, which when highlighted says Run ADB commands, and click it, and then click Custom Command option from the drop-down menu. Step 3, in the white box, we are going to copy and paste these commands and hit Run Command after each one. Check for written versions and description to make sure it's exact. Step 4, once the three custom commands have been input, we then go back to the top right and click the wrench icon, which brings up a whole bunch of options here. These are the ones we're going to change. Refresh rate has to be set to 60 Hz, Guardian set to off, and full rate capture to on. Step 5. Once all settings have been input correctly, you can grab your headset, press power button to get out of sleep mode, press power button again to put it back into sleep mode, and then once more to bring it out of sleep mode. This step is critical, and if not done, can lead to several settings not being recognized properly and ruin your footage. I suggest doing a test recording and taking a look to make sure it looks high quality and 60 FPS from within the headset before any major recording setup, as these settings will be wiped if you restart the headset or the battery dies and it shuts off. It majorly sucks to record a day of footage to find it was captured in 20 FPS and the footage is useless. This method was taught to me by the developer of Mutated Virus and Bionic Hunter, so massive thank you to them, as this video is only possible because of them.
You're unstoppable.
Okay, so we've got 4K, our footage is looking amazing, and we're ready to upload. But wait, what about the audio? So, one big thing for making a video online is, of course, your recording. You can use the Quest's built-in recording, but if you're going to this much effort to get into 4K, I have a feeling that's not going to be good enough for you. So, we gotta get to the next step. And the next step requires Audacity. And Audacity is a free program on your computer that you can record voiceovers, and it's got tons of things to edit your voiceovers. I'm gonna do a quick rundown and show you how I edit my audio to get the vocal sound the best I can get. It does help to do this kind of stuff. It'll clean up your videos. It doesn't take a lot of effort, and it's generally just easy to do. So let's get into that process.
So for this process, it's really very simple. In Audacity, set the mic volume down so it won't spike. I usually have mine set between 0.5 and the 0.7 mark. Then I hit record and usually do quick mic tests to ensure it's all working correctly. Then I record my vocal track, and at the end, I usually like to create mouth noises and general background noise for 15 to 20 seconds. Once all this is done, we will highlight the part at the end with the mouth noises and background noise, and then Effect, Noise Reduction, Get Noise Profile. Then we hit Control A to highlight the whole track. Then we go back to Effect, Noise Reduction, but this time we hit OK. Then I hit Normalize, then OK. Then I hit Compressor and OK. Make sure your numbers are all set the same for these, as changing this stuff can lead to different results, but these will keep the audio on the same level to avoid audio spikes that can hurt people's ears. You can leave it at that, but I also like to add some extra boost to my vocal tracks, so I like to use bass and treble and graphic equalizer effects. And again, you can see the numbers I am using on screen if you want to match those, but you may find it better to tweak them based on your own voice and mic. I'm using a Blue Yeti podcast mic, for example. Also, for while you're recording, you may find throwing blankets down or holding a pillow absorbs the sound better, making for higher quality vocal track, something that can be the most important thing at keeping viewers from clicking outside of the video.
Okay, so we got our video, we got the video part, we got the sound part, but we gotta edit it all together. So we need a video editing program. Now, there's a ton of options you can pick between. The program that I use is Movavi, and it is a paid program, so if you're interested in that, they do have a free like demo trial version you can check out to give it a test for it. It's really, really easy. If you don't know how to edit videos that great, it makes all sorts of complex looking things a lot simpler. The downside though is that it does restrict you in terms of how complex things can really get, so even doing things like circular overlays require workarounds. So I love Movavi, and it's really great for people that are new to making videos, but that's as much as I'm going to say on that, because I do have a video about using Movavi if you're interested. But I will say, for VR content, the fast cutting looks fancy, but it's sometimes hard to follow from a gameplay standpoint if you're doing a video or viewing it. So if you can try to keep your gameplay clips to around 10 to 15 seconds, it's going to be a lot easier for your audience to maintain engagement, and it's going to be a lot easier for you to edit the videos, so keep that in mind. Now, the last thing I want to talk about, and probably the most important thing, is marketing. And marketing a video for YouTube requires several key things. The biggest thing, well, you have to do it, is your thumbnail. And your thumbnail is what people are going to see first. Probably before the title itself, they're going to see that thumbnail. So the more vague and appealing you make it, the more likely people are going to click on it. But if the video is not good, or the video is not on par with whatever they clicked on, a lot of people will click out of it, and that'll kill that video. So it's kind of a balancing act. I know a lot of the bigger guys use multiple thumbnails and cycle through them to find out which one is getting the most clicks, and that you can definitely do that. But I think ultimately, when it comes to a thumbnail, you want big objects and big text. That seems to be the winning formula. So I don't always do that. I like to include screenshots, but big items, big text, you know, that's the way to do it. A big picture of the Oculus Quest with Oculus Quest info. That's how you get a video watched. But that's marketing right there. On top of the marketing though, we can use tags and all those types of things. We can share on Twitter, we can share on Facebook, we can share on Reddit. Those types of things are kind of as much as you want to share it around. But for YouTube itself, I think just focusing on that thumbnail, focusing on making the video awesome, and making sure the audio is good on top of the video quality. I think if you get those things done, you're going to do ultimately just so much better. Your videos are going to look so much nicer, and the developers are going to be so much more interested in sending you game keys. That is another thing I didn't bring up in this video, but I'll do a quick little thing on that. Game keys. You can apply through all sorts of websites like Keymailer to try to get game keys through, you know, a more automated program, but you don't have to use those things, and for VR, you really don't need to. I've found the ultimate way to just get keys is to just reach out, message developers. If you're on App Lab stuff, you're looking for App Lab stuff, you're looking to cover App Lab stuff, most of these developers are just happy you're going to make a video on their stuff. They don't care if you have 50,000 subscribers or you have 50 subscribers. They're usually going to toss you a key if you're going to make a video. When it comes to the bigger stuff like Resident Evil 4, you know, you're going to have to talk to the right people, but, you know, I saw channels with less than 2,000 subscribers that were getting keys, and I was like, yeah, you know what, I should have asked. So, you know, find these email addresses, go to their websites, look for the companies, you can get keys. So all those things combined, you know, you're dead set on it. Combined with the fact that there's tons of free SideQuest and App Lab stuff, free Rec Room stuff, VR chat, Horizon Worlds, Alt Space, all of those things, there is an infinite amount of stuff you can cover for VR. There's no reason for you to say, I don't have anything to make a video on. Message me. I got so many video ideas. It's blowing my mind. There's no way I could ever make all of these ideas. So that is that. Definitely focus on list type videos for higher success. But hey, you never know. Some of these individual ones do well. And the most important thing above all else for being a VR YouTuber is to have fun. Because this is what this is. This is about having fun. The VR industry is not popular enough. You're not going to make money. You're not going to be a world famous YouTuber. But it could be there in a few years. You could build towards that. And you know what? There are the rare occasion of people who have taken off like that. But I'm running out of breath. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I hope all of your footage is 4K going forward. Hope it looks awesome. And if you are making videos using this guide, if you want people to check out your new reborn content, leave a comment below and let's check out these channels. And you know what? If you got a 4K TV, you're going to want to subscribe to these channels because it's going to look nice. So that's that. Hope you guys enjoyed this guide. And again, please, you know, leaving a like, dropping a comment, and subscribing helps me so much. And honestly, it tells me what kind of videos people want to watch. So if this is the kind of video you want to watch on this channel, doing all you can, we'll make sure that more of those videos exist on this channel. But I'm out of here. Thank you guys so much for watching.